Grace here, and we are welcoming a new member to our plushie family zoo. I don't know, I just made that up. Yes. I cannot really open the boxes with my left hand, so I'm going to swap hands because I'm right-handed. I don't know why I even tried to do it left-handedly. But I'm doing this all in one hand so I can hold my camera. Okay. Yes, you like my blue sheep? Anyway. After all of the randomness is done. Yeah, that's why I'm opening things with one hand. Our new person. I'm not person, but our new. Build-A-Bear plushies, and work it out with just that. You know, actually, I did this online, right? I did this online, because this is the online bundle. I actually put a name in that, I believe. And it happened with some of the others, but they never got printed with their actual name on it. Which is really annoying for me, because obviously I put the name on it. Oh, look at that! There's a coat hanger. Why is there a coat hanger? Probably for one of the things that's... Whoops. Because I ordered it with everything already on, so... Or they could just put them in by accident, but... Yes, so let me just... I'll be right back. Okay, now we're back on the bed. So you see, there is the front door to bed. You don't actually have the thing where it, you know, opens that way. But, can you tell what it is? Little windows here. You should do. You've probably already seen it on Leon Hart's video or on his Twitter or Instagram, but I totally actually didn't know when this was coming out. So, and I happened to come across Leon Hart's post, and what do you have it? And what do you know? It's not coming out. Oh, so cute. Oops, I'm gonna pull it by its ear because I can't really pull it out anyway. And inside the box, the little guys. I'm not sure if they're called guys, actually. And a card. So let me just put her little house on the floor. Oops. Okay. Here is her wonderful glory. So, I'm going to take this. So I kind of keep the, tags on. I like keeping tags on things. Well, on some things anyway. But this is the, little hoodie. It's cute and so soft. So here's... Very cute. And this is Velcro. So smooth. And this is very pretty. And a little butt ear. Though, it doesn't have much of a head to actually really be in this because, like, it's not much of a head to a thing. But, there we go. And that is the Vulpix. It's got lovely, like, as it says, there's white and blue details, color. And very, very pretty. Though without this, obviously, then it looks... This is the under of it. Little circles. And let's see. than this. Now, you want to hear her, don't you? So, somewhere. Six. Okay, it's been round all, I think. I mean, that's very pretty and very soft. Okay, so that is that with the little snow capey kind of thing. Do you even know what it's called? It's got a tag in here. Alolan cape. So initially would be 10 pounds. Ooh. Okay, so the next thing. It's quite nice, it's got like a little spot for the tip. So, like, you know, lays flush. See? Anyway. So cute. This jammy thing, who is it? Well, I guess it is a jammy. It's the Alolan Sleeper. Can't really see it because it's blurred, but anyways, that would have been another 10 pounds. Well, obviously, this sleeper, I got a glimpse of the ceiling here. Let's put this on. Okay, so we see. Buffalo, yeah. This would be under her. Let's see. Should we put her on? Should we put it on? I don't really want to lose it, do I? I guess the cape was is what this was for. Maybe. What was it for this? I guess it could have been for this. I'll just bring in the other one I have in the sleeper, so let's put it on. Let's put her on her knees. Sweep up your foot paw, yeah. Okay. Done. There. What is this? Your left paw. Then you gotta put your back paw and shake it all about. Okay. Bones are on one of the duvet folds. So I can have both hands free to do this. Alright, so move the cape out of the way. Space for its tail. And of course it would be less hassle if I took the tails off, but I'm going to keep them on. And you put fold the labels in. That one sure looks all cute. Velcro bits back on. Yes, there's the Velcro bits. So pretty. In a lowering sleeper and the cape. I just love the cape. The cape is so pretty. Don't you think so? So pretty. So soft. Obviously, it's got like Pokeballs, and I have no idea. That's what the grass like, or no idea. But it's all pretty and like little furry bits. Anyway, what you're also looking forward to is the card. Ta-da! From I think it was Guardians Rising. Yep, it's too bad they don't make these hollow graphic. Like they do for the Toys R Us, some Toys R Us ones and stuff. But in this all thing, so obviously I'm going to keep it sealed. Like so. Put in one of those ultra pro sleeves, you know. And voila! We have double protection. Anyway, yes, so pretty. Yes, that is everything, I believe. So pretty. It would make more sense if they released this during Christmas, not before Halloween, but there we go. I wonder what Pokemon will come out with next. That should be interesting. And so far I have all of them. So obviously comes with the birth certificate thing, as I showed before. Still a little myth that they don't put the name and date of birth thing. And the belongs to, yeah, they sometimes fill that in actually. This time they didn't fill it in at all. So that's slightly annoying when I didn't fill it in myself. And I can't remember if I filled it in on this one. But I know I filled it in on the other one and they still didn't put it in. But anyway. At least they didn't mess up the plushie. That's the main thing. So yes. So if you want to, you know, the proper Build-A-Bear stuffing experience, you can, you know, check out Leonhardt's video, I think. Obviously, I ordered my online, so I got the online bundle. And this was like, plus postage, maybe 15 pounds in total. So yeah. Yeah, I just remember now. So, thank you for watching. Like, subscribe for more. Ring that doorbell. Over and out.